After we measured and placed walls in our previous tutorial videos, we now want to include doors. This is done analog to the windows we have seen placed earlier. Therefore, we also use the automatically existing panoramic views in PointCab. Use the mouse wheel or the plus or minus button to adjust the accuracy of the representation. Keep the mouse button pressed or use arrow keys to move the segment into the active window. Make sure the button for CAD for connection to Revit and 3D points is enabled. With the function Insert Door, we create doors in PointCab for Revit. In the dialog box, we choose a door of variable size. We also measure the size of our doors or passageways with the circumferential measurement tool. Revit requires no lower point for doors because the door is always determined by the lower plane of the wall. We have to always measure the first point on the side of the stopper in order to transfer this point. The bounding rectangle is determined just like the window by points in two opposite corners, for example, points to the left and above and on the right. Please click the last point twice to complete the circumferential measurement. Additionally, to fit the door, we have to transmit the opening direction. We click on the doorstep to indicate that the door opens toward us. Should the door have to open up the other direction, we switch over to the PointCab floor plan and click a point behind the door. It is also possible to insert doors with predetermined dimensions. As we have done previously in the window, we go to Options and search for tolerances. Round determines whether the tolerance should be set to round up or down. Then we select the door dialog in the door family and pick a family name. Revit will then search for a suitable door in the family for a door in the appropriate size. Should no matching door be found within these tolerances, a new family will be created. That's all on the doors. In the next video, we will look at how we measure openings and passageways in walls.